Jai Shri Gurudev, our next lecture video is to solve a problem number 7. Is a square pyramid of base side 40 mm and height 70 mm rest symmetrically on a cube of edge 50 mm, which itself is placed on a cylinder of diameter 80 mm and thickness 30 mm. Draw the isometric projections of the solids if the axis of the three solids are in common line. Now up to the previous problem we solved only two solids, the combination of two solids. Now here given three solids is given. First solid is square pyramid of base side is how much? 40 mm and height is 70 mm. As you know, this is a square pyramid. The base of the square pyramid is a square shape and having apex, right? Of base how much? 40 mm and height is 70 mm. Next, second solid is cube of edge 50 mm. All sides of that solid is equal in length. That is a cube of how much? This is a cube is 50 mm. The length is also 50, width also 50, height also 50 mm. Next, the cylinder. The cylinder diameter is 80 mm and thickness is 30 mm. Now this is a cylinder of diameter is how much? 80 mm and thickness is 30 mm. What is the conditions? A square pyramid is rest on a cube and cube is placed on a cylinder. See, the square pyramid is rest on a cube and cube is placed on a cylinder and axis of three solids are in common line. What is the axis of three solids are in common line, right? This is a combination of three solids problem, right? Now this is draw the orthographic projection of the combination of three solids. This is a top view and front view. First you draw a cylinder. In the top view it's a circular shape. What is the diameter is 80 mm and project it into vertical front view in vertical plane. That is thickness is almost 30 mm. In front view it looks as a rectangular shape, right? Then you go for mark this a cube. Cube is almost dimension 50 mm. From the center here leave the 25 mm. On the both side 25 mm, on upper side as a 25 and bottom is 25 mm. Mark the point, then draw a horizontal line and vertical line. That intersection point will get a cube. Cube of how much? The edge is 50 mm. Then draw the vertical projector that is placed over on a cylinder. Now it is as a cube, right? A square shape it is. Then over that again a square pyramid is placed of size how much? 40 mm. Again from the center take 20 mm on each side, 20 mm on each side, then draw a horizontal line and vertical line on the marked point and apex is O3. Then join the corners of the square pyramid to the apex. Now this is the top view of the square pyramid. So project that vertical project, draw the vertical projector. Then the cube is placed over where? Sorry, the square pyramid is placed over where? Cube, right? From the cube on the axis, see that this is a measure 20 mm on each side and apex you'll get 70 mm from the center of the cube, center of the pyramid. Then you'll get the is a triangular shape, right? Now this is what orthographic projection of a three combination of solids. Now this is the isometric projection of the combination of three solids. As you know that first place a cylinder. How to place a cylinder here? Now you can place this cylinder in a rectangular box. 1 suffix 1, 2 suffix 1, C 3 suffix 1, 4 suffix 1 for the base. And also top is 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Now first make first you draw the square box. 1 suffix 1, 2 suffix 1, 3 suffix 1 and 4 suffix 1. How much here? 80 mm is nothing but 8 blocks. Similarly, then go for draw a bottom face of the cylinder, that is a ellipse, and also from the each corner of the block draw a vertical line. On the vertical line how much you measured here? 30 mm, is 3 blocks. Again you go for construct one a square box, that is the top face of the cylinder, 1, 2, 3 and 4, and again you go for draw ellipse, right? Then draw the tangent to this ellipse, then you complete the cylinder. After completion of the cylinder, first solid, then you draw join the major diagonal, minor diagonal, the intersection point will get the center of the top face of the cylinder. From the center, now what is the next one? Next, I want to draw the cube, right? Cube from the center is how much it is? From the cube from the center it is 25 mm. In the horizontal and vertical so it is 25 mm. We have total 50 divided by 2, 25 mm. Now from this center, along the 30 degree line, how much block you want to measure? 25 means 2.5 blocks. 1, 2, 2.5 blocks. And then draw a 150 degree line. Similarly, on the another side of 30 degree line, measure 2.5 blocks and mark the point and draw a 150 degree line. Now from the center here, on the 150 degree line, measure 2.5 blocks and draw a 30 degree line. And on the another side also, measure 2.5 blocks and draw a 150 degree line. The intersection point will be called as, what is the base, bottom face of the cube, it is P1, Q1, R1, S1, right? Same thing you mark here, the intersection of those, the line 30 degree and 150 degree line, you get P1, Q1, R1, S1, right? Then join this. Then join this, you will get a bottom face of the cube. Then you will go from the each corner of the, from the each base corner, draw a vertical line. On the vertical, how much you are going to measure here? What is the height of the cube? It is also a 50 mm, right? Now measure is 5 blocks on the each base corner of the cube. Then you will get the top face of the cube by joining the, that is called as PQ, PQ or S. It is P, Q, R, S, right? Now that completes the, a cube is resting over the cylinder on the same center line. Next, after that, now what is the next one? It is a square pyramid of side how much? Size 40 mm. Again, from the center is how much it is? On each side it is 20 mm, right? Now mark the center of the top face of the cube. How do you get the center of the top face of the cube? By joining P and R and Q and S, the intersection point, there's a major diagonal and minor diagonal, the intersection point will get the center of the cube, name it as O2. From the center, how much I want to measure here on 30 degree line? 20 mm is how much? 2 blocks, mark it and draw a 150 degree line. On another side also, on the 30 degree line, mark 2 blocks and draw a 150 degree line. On 150 degree line also measure 20 mm and draw a 30 degree line. Similarly on another side of 150 degree line, then draw a 30 degree line. The intersection point will get the top face, the base of the square pyramid, that is U, V, W, X, right? See that U, V, W, X. Then you get the same from the center of the square pyramid, draw a vertical line. On the vertical line, what is the height of the cube? It is 70 mm, right? Yeah, from the center of the cube, draw a vertical line. On this vertical line, how much you are going to measure is 70 mm means 7 blocks. You measure 7 blocks and mark it as O3. From O3, draw a slant edges O3 to W, O3 to V, O3 to U. Now O3 to X is invisible lines, right? Then what about the, and again, what are the intersection of this cube and the square pyramid, a slant edge? Up to this only it is visible. These are invisible. Either show dash line or leave it. The or continuous decline, you can show this construction line. Remaining these are visible. Similarly, this cube, this face and this face is visible. And it comes to a cylinder, where the top face of the cylinder, it touches the cube, up to this only is visible, right? From here it is up to this only visible, this top face, and this is the front, the observer is here, this visible, up to this one is visible, and these are the tangent to the base and top face ellipse. Now this is what? The combination of three, so isometric position of combination of three solids. Similarly, try this problem number, this assignment 5, 30, 31, 42. Out of 4, any 2 problems you try and send to my number. Now thank you for watching this video.